गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी. ओके, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी. सो इन साइकोलॉजी वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड जर्नी ऑफ साइकोलॉजी देन बेसिक साइकोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस. ओके, एंड टुडे वी विल स्टडी कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी. सो prior to it, what is psychology? We have already discussed what definition we have done. But one thing you have to keep in your mind always, what? That psychology has started its journey from study of soul. Means earlier it was believed that the psychology is a study of soul. Then it has replaced from soul to study of mind. Study of mind. And then it has replaced from mind to study of conscious experience, then from study of conscious experience. Okay, and at last we have reached where study of behavior. So see, in psychology we have shifted from soul to mind, mind to conscious experience, and at last we have reached behavior. Still in psychology experiments are going on and experiments are going on for the new definition, but it is apt what? It is apt definition, worldwide accepted definition, what? That psychology is formally a science which studies experiences, behavior, mental processes in different contexts. So we have reached study of behavior. And I have already cleared it what? That earlier it was believed that soul, then from soul to mind, mind to conscious experience, and at last behavior. Behavior, study of behavior means study of man, human being, and an organism. And in organism we can take animals. So organism means human being and animals. Fine. So basically psychology is what? Study of behavior. Now we have done up to here, we have done psychological processes and basic psychological processes. Now we will understand what definition, concept of psychology. Okay, so today we will understand concept of psychology, really what is psychology and what you all people are going to study in psychology. Psychology ka concept kya hai aur aap psychology mein kya padhne wale hain. So first of all we have to understand what is psychology or worldwide definition of psychology. Psychology is formally a science. Psychology is formally a science. Fine. Why science? Because in psychology we are doing experiments. So that's why we are collecting data. We are keeping records. So that's why psychology is a science where we do experiments. Okay. So it is a natural science. We can say it. It's a part of science. So psychology is formally a science which studies mental processes, which studies mental processes, then experiences, behavior in different context. Okay, so psychology is formally a science which studies mental processes. Means being a psychology student, you are going to study mental processes. So the mental processes means what? Brain and mind. Lot of difference between brain and mind. Why? I'll explain you with example. Brain which you can locate, brain जिसको आप locate कर सकते, brain you can see the brain, but you are not able to see the activity. So mind does the activity. Mind does the activity, and we all are different in our activities. I'll give you explanation of this mental process. Then experiences and behavior and different context. Behavior, I'll explain you, and different context. So basically, in psychology, what we are going to study, what is psychology? Study of science, which studies mental processes, experiences and behavior. Okay, so that's why, have you seen psychiatrists, those who give what medicines, and psychologists, those who treat the patient with what their views, opinions and all, we will see later on. But first of all, we have to understand the concept of psychology. Okay, so now we will understand mental process. So what is psychology? You have to recall it. What is psychology? Psychology is a science which studies mental processes. So what is mental process? Mental process means it is the state we use to solve problems. So it is the state that we use to solve the problems, means brain. Suppose in case a question is given to you in classroom, a puzzle, aapke teacher ne aapko ek puzzle diya. Now around 40 students are sitting in a class and everyone will try to solve that puzzle, but someone will solve that puzzle in a quick glance, koi bahut jaldi karega, someone will take time. So what is it? Brain to sabka hai, but ye kya hai? It is activity, how our mind works on that puzzle. So it is a state we use to solve problems, then we use for thinking, then we use for thinking various aspects like remember, recall, okay, etc. So what is mental processes? It is means brain you can locate, brain is visible, you can see brain, but you are not able to see that mental process. Suppose in case I have given a question, 2 × 2 × 6 / 9. So students, whatever the process students are taking to solve that puzzle, to solve that riddle, to solve that question, is mental process. Okay, is mental. How, suppose in case a question is given to you and mark is 10, but everyone is not scoring 10. Why? Because everyone is using mental process over there, and mental process depends on person to person, how they activate their mind at that time. So it is mental process, it is the state we use to solve problems, thinking, various aspects like remember, recall, etc. Fine, we perceive. Kabhi kabhi aisa bhi hota, hum kya perceive karte hain, hum kya feel karte hain, then we solve that problem. Suppose in case somebody is telling me pity story, mujhe bahut hi koi aisi kahani bata raha hai, I have perceived that story, then I will try to solve. तो जो मैं सॉल्व करूंगी परसीव करके, दैट इज ऑल्सो मेंटल प्रोसेस. फाइन, देन कम्स द सेकेंड पॉइंट ऑफ आवर डेफिनेशन इज व्हाट एक्सपीरियंसेस इज व्हाट एक्सपीरियंस इज व्हाट बेटा experience is subjective in nature. Experience is subjective in nature. Now see, understand over here, what is subjective in nature? As I am doing yoga over here, and I can understand what do I feel. Jo main feel kar sakti hu, you will not feel that enjoyment, you will not feel that soothing environment, because experience is subjective, very from person to person. A very small child is there and he doesn't want to do yoga, he would like to play games. तो उसको योगा में वो एक्सपीरियंस नहीं मिलेगा जो मुझे मिल रहा है. He has a very harsh experience in yoga, maybe. And I have very good experience. I have enjoyed a lot in yoga. Okay, so students would like to play games. So they share different kind of the experience. Unko boys ko cricket khelna achha lagta hai. So what does it mean? It means that they like that experience of playing games. But aap jaise aisa group hai jo ki dance bahut karte hain but they don't want to play cricket. So they will not like to enjoy. To unka experience us game mein achha nahi hoga. To experience is subjective in nature. Experience is subjective in nature and which are subjective in nature, which are embedded. It is very important that experience subjective in nature, which are embedded in our conscious awareness. In our conscious awareness. Very important points. Experiences are subjective in nature, which are embedded in our conscious awareness and depends on internal and external conditions. Internal and external condition of a person. Now, I have invited you to enjoy a party. मैंने आपको invite किया एक party को enjoy करने के लिए. Okay. Now I would like to tell you how does experience change. हमारा experience कैसे change करता है. Means what we share, what we feel कैसे change करता है. So I have invited you on a party. And experience subjective in nature, which are embedded in our conscious. मतलब experience we are aware कि हमें क्या feel हो रहा है, इस समय क्या feel हो रहा है, and depends on internal and external condition of a person. Suppose in case, मैं आपको ये बताती हूँ कि ऐसा होता है कि you would like to enjoy, आपको enjoy करना है, but in the morning you fell down from somewhere or you have pain in your leg, आपके leg में pain हो रहा है, you will not enjoy that party. ये आपका experience है, but बाकी बच्चे, all other children are enjoying. Why? Because आप अपना experience क्या कर रहे हो मन में, means you are in pain, so you are not able to enjoy that party. Suppose in case it's a very humid in classroom, you would like to on the AC. Okay, आपको experience क्या हो रहा है, बहुत ही hot लग रहा है and you are not comfortable. एक और student आता है and he is ill, he is shivering and he doesn't want to sit in that AC, so he will feel comfortable in that classroom. Okay, in that classroom, why he will not feel comfortable? He will feel comfortable in that classroom. क्यों? क्योंकि he is ill. So experience depends on internal and external condition. Suppose in case you are not happy, तो आप कभी भी आपको अच्छा experience feel नहीं होगा. And it depends on person to person. जैसे मैंने बताया कि student है, he will enjoy the party. But एक aged man है, he would like to sit under a tree. I will make a student to sit under a tree. He will not sit under the tree. Why he will not enjoy? वो बोलेगा अच्छा ही नहीं लग रहा है. Why? Because experience depends on internal and external condition. And everyone's experience is different. Fine. Now, behavior. What is behavior? Behavior is response. आपने जो feel किया है, after that आपने जो experience किया है, after that what you react, that is behavior. What you react, that is behavior. Behavior is what? It is the response of an action. Means how you respond, how you react on any condition. आप कैसे रिएक्ट करते हैं, ये होता है बिहेवियर, ठीक है। ये भी पर्सन टू पर्सन बताती हूँ, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ बिहेवियर आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, कोवर्ट एंड ओवर्ट, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू लेटर ऑन, बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज बिहेवियर, होता क्या है बिहेवियर। मेंटल प्रोसेस, हाउ आवर माइंड एक्टिवेट, हाउ आवर माइंड वर्क्स, कैसे वर्क करता है, उसको हम कहते हैं वॉट एक्टिविटी, जो प्रोसेस हम यूज करते हैं टू सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम, क्विज, ओके, थिंकिंग, रिमेंबरिंग, वी कॉल इट मेंटल प्रोसेस। एक्सपीरियंस, वॉट वी फील, ओके, एट दैट टाइम वो होता है एक्सपीरियंस, वॉट वी फील, वॉट वी शेयर। बिहेवियर इज डिफरेंट थिंग, बिहेवियर हमारा रेस्पॉन्ड टू अ स्टिमुली, हमारा आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू, हमारा रिएक्शन। सपोज इन केस आप you are going somewhere and suddenly what is there, suddenly you face a strong storm, then you will feel awkward, wo to aapka experience, lekin you will shout over there, ye aapka behavior hai, okay। aapka haath kisi garm cheez pe laga, so your aapka jo hand hoga, it will come, it will be what that come out from that fire and you will ouch, so what is it, it is behavior। so behavior is what, behavior is respond, response to an action। suppose your teacher is there in the classroom and she is appreciating you, so you will smile, aap smile karenge, so it is behavior, aapka behavior। your teacher is scolding you and you will cry, so it is also behavior, aap ro rahe hain, okay। to ye hota hai behavior। now behavior are of two types, first one is covert and second one is overt। Overt behavior is noticeable, visible, overt behavior is visible and covert behavior is what, unnoticeable, that you don't notice, we call it covert behavior। why, because see, covert and overt, covert unnoticeable behavior and overt behavior visible, that you visible, जो आप visible करते हैं उसको हम कहते हैं overt। I would like to explain you, as you are sitting somewhere, okay, and suddenly your brother is there in the room and he has given you a tight hug, then you will feel happy and you will also give him hug and say him what, good, I'm happy with you, you have brought laurels, tum bahut acha result leke aaye ho, main bahut khush hu, okay। so it is your observable behavior, lekin आप स्कूल गए, इन द स्कूल योर टीचर इज स्कोल्डेड यू, आपके टीचर ने आपको डांटा, वॉट विल यू डू, यू विल क्राई, नहीं आप रोएंगे नहीं, यू विल हाइड योर फीलिंग्स, यू वुड लाइक टू डू आर्ग्यूमेंटेशन विद द टीचर, बट यू विल नॉट डू, वाई, बिकॉज यू नो वॉट इज द डेकोरम ऑफ द स्कूल, यू विल हाइड योर फीलिंग्स। तो ये क्या है, आपका covert behavior है, means you will not share your that behavior, you don't want anyone to notice your behavior, but same thing has happened at your home, somebody has scolded you, आपके घर में आपको किसी ने scold किया, and you know that parents and family, although I don't favor कि आपको किसी के साथ में argumentation करना चाहिए, but you do argumentation over there, why, because you know that nobody will say anything to you, तो ये क्या होता है, overt behavior, noticeable behavior, okay। a child is at home, he can jump, he can dance, okay, whenever he is happy, so it is noticeable behavior, but same situation is in the classroom, he will not show his behavior, वो अपना behavior नहीं show करता, तो यही तो कहते हैं extrovert and introvert, introvert वो होते हैं जो कि अपना शो नहीं कर पाते बिहेवियर को, अपनी फीलिंग्स को, एंड एक्सट्रोवर्ट दोज हु शो देयर फीलिंग्स, दोज हु आर इन लाइमलाइट एंड ऑल, तो ओवर्ट बिहेवियर एंड कोवर्ट बिहेवियर, सो इट इज ओवर्ट इज विजिबल एंड कोवर्ट इज अननोटिसेबल। सपोज इन केस यू हैव सीन अ वुंडेड पर्सन, आपने वुंडेड पर्सन को देखा है फ्रॉम योर फैमिली, आपकी फैमिली से कोई वुंडेड है, किसी को बहुत चोट पहुंची है, सो यू विल रिएक्ट ओवर देयर, यू विल क्राई एंड यू विल व्हाट हैज हैपेंड टू यू, आई विल टेक यू टू द हॉस्पिटल, वॉट एवर यू बिहेव एट दैट टाइम, दैट इज ओवर बिहेवियर। आप डॉक्टर, प्लीज डॉक्टर हेल्प मी, एंड इफ डॉक्टर इज नॉट रेडी देन यू विल शाउट, ये होता है ओवर्ट बिहेवियर। बट कोवर्ट इज वॉट, दैट यू विल कीप योर सेल्फ काम बिकॉज यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू हर्ट दैट पेशेंट, आपको उसको पेशेंट को हर्ट नहीं करना है, तो आप अपने आप को क्या करेंगे, काम करेंगे, एंड यू विल नॉट शो योर फीलिंग्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ द डॉक्टर, ऑल्दो डॉक्टर इज नॉट डूइंग हिज ड्यूटी प्रॉपरली, मान लीजिए डॉक्टर अपना ड्यूटी पूरा नहीं करा, बट स्टिल यू विल रिमेन काम ओवर देयर. मीन्स यू हैव द ग्रज बट यू आर नॉट शोइंग योर ग्रज. सो वॉट इज इट? इट इज कोवर्ट बिहेवियर. कोवर्ट अननोटिसेबल बिहेवियर दैट यू हाइड योर फीलिंग्स, जो आप फीलिंग्स अपनी छुपाते हैं, ओवर दैट यू शो योर फीलिंग्स. ओके, सो इट इज वॉट? इट इज साइकोलॉजी डेफिनेशन. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन इन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी एंड वॉट यू ऑल आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन साइकोलॉजी. आप साइकोलॉजी में क्या पढ़ेंगे? मेंटल प्रोसेस, बिहेवियर ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग, एनिमल्स एंड वॉट एंड एक्सपीरियंसेस. डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट. वॉट इज डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट? डिफरेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट मीन्स cultural context, cultural context, then social environment, fine, different contexts, external condition, internal condition, cultural context, how you behave in society, how do you behave in family, how do you behave with your family member, different context. So we are going to study all these things in psychology. So have you got my point? So if you have that misconcept that you are going to study brain, wrong. You are not going to study brain, you are not going to study anyone, you are going to study what? You are going to study behavior, you are going to study mental processes, you are going to study experiences, and you will see that how you have to do experiments. Hum experiments karte hain, we will do experiments, okay, to get the better results. Okay, so this is psychology. Okay, this is psychology where we will study mind, where we will study behavior, where we will study experiences in different contexts. Fine, so please go through this definition, please go through the concept of psychology, and it is it is an advice to you, go through the previous videos, introduction of psychology, then basic psychological processes in two parts, and then finally we have reached the concept of psychology, and then we will discuss psychology as a discipline, natural science or social science. We will discuss it in our further classes, but first of all go through the concept of psychology, and I'm sending you the PDF for the first chapter. Please do it in your notebook. Thank you. Have a nice day.